Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at how to adjust the time and the location of your photographs in the Photos app. So let's start by taking a look at a photo and adjusting its date and time. So I'm just going to go into a single photo here in Photos, and under Image I can just easily do Adjust Date and Time. Now here's where it shows me the original, and I can do adjusted right here, and I can set any date or time I want, adjust it any way that I want. So I can change the month, for instance, and I can also then change the time zone, which is something that you commonly need to do because maybe you take pictures with your camera and you're on a vacation and you're a different time zone, but your camera doesn't know that. Your iPhone will, but your camera won't. So then you can adjust the time zone to whatever you need, and you could do a search like that. And you can hit adjust, and now it changes it, and you see there at the top. So this is very handy, and the cool thing is you can do this with multiple photos. So for instance, I can select these two photos here, and I can adjust date and time on both of those. So let me go ahead and change this to another month, and I'll also change the time zone and adjust. And it will adjust it for both of those photos. So now if I go in and I can see there it says April and April for both of those photos. So if you have a whole bunch of photos that don't have a proper timestamp on them, you can select them all and then set them using Image Adjust Date and Time. So new in El Capitan is the ability in Photos to change the location or set it. For instance, this photo here was taken with a camera, didn't have any GPS in it. So if I go to it and I get information on it, so Window Info or Command I, I can see it's got no location. I can easily now assign a location. So I can just type something and it's going to do a search for me. So here I get Denver Museum of Nature and Science. That's indeed where I took this photo. And I can select it, and now it has set that location. You can see it's even reflected that change here. And now it shows me a map here, which is what I would see if this was a photo I took with my iPhone and it had the location set. Now you can actually navigate in this map by dragging it around, using the plus and minus buttons, that kind of thing. And I can even click and hold on this pin and then move it around and put it someplace more accurate. So that might help a lot right there. You can do a lot of other things. Like for instance, you can enter in, you can go in here and type again something else, and you can try searching for a location, but you could also even enter in longitude and latitude. So I'm going to go into Safari here, and in Safari I can go to Google Maps, and one of the cool features of Google Maps is I can control click on a location, hit what's here, and it gives me longitude and latitude, and I'm going to copy that, and then I'm going to go back in here and I'm going to paste longitude and latitude there. And that will work as well. So you can actually locate places that are not near any other place. You're out in the wilderness. You can use longitude and latitude, if you have it, to enter in a location. So some other tips here. You can select multiple photos, Command I, and assign a location to all of those. So that's handy for vacation photos. You take a bunch of pictures at a museum, you can easily assign them a location. You can also revert to your image location. Now those photos didn't have any, but if I were to go to something I took more recently and that I know was taken with an iPhone, there you go, and this one has a location already, you can see that I have those there. So I can remove the location, revert to original location, so I can set a bunch of locations and then decide I want to go back to the one that's embedded in the actual photo file that was taken with the camera. So you have the ability to remember that one as well as assigning one manually here in the Photos app.